Alright, fools, welcome to a new series. I'm gonna play Empyrion. Gonna get my water. I'm gonna get out my trusty survival tool. And I'm gonna wander away from the wreckage and see what there is to do. So, yeah. This is really invigorating commentary. Now, I'll be doing this. I have played this the game. I could be wrong about this, but here's some copper. The game appears to be in three acts. At least the standard hello personal log files restored. I'll take a look at that in a second. But level two. What am I getting at? Oh, I've played what seems to be the first act several times. I'm relatively comfortable with it now. So for anybody who's never seen this game, excuse me, if anybody's never seen this game or played this game but has any interest, you might take this first part as, I don't know, play-acted tutorial or something. Just a fairly aggressive, quick, not necessarily, blast through the early stuff. And as of yet, after many playthroughs, I still haven't even gotten into the second act. I've just gotten caught up in the whole building of ships and stuff. So that will continue to happen, but I figured I'll record it because, hey, I asked and one person was interested, so good enough, right? Alright, so, okay, one can salvage. Did you know that you can salvage? Supplies are very helpful later on. Can be a bit monotonous in this early stage with this peon little tool. So we won't continue. I'll head off over there. Oh, wait a minute. Heard something about a PDF. First, click the headline that says personal log file. Emergency situation detected. Robinson Protocol, UCHA 101. Can you get off my dang screen? It's one of the problems with this layout is there's so many overlapping messages. They need to do something about that. Presumably, well, we're still in alpha. You can see up there in the corner. Still in alpha. Okay, now I can read. Good luck, Chief. One medium armor. Your PDA has necessary mission infinos. The MP. Pyro PDA. Oh, get off my damn screen! Seriously! Sorry, guys. Come on. I want to read. Create some energy bars. Bandages. Yeah, I've got all that. Nice lake. Oh! And there's the wreckage. I expected that. I don't know if you guys did. So this plant, this is good. I need this plant for fuel. For some early tools. Later on, it becomes basically pointless, but... So that plant was for fuel. This plant here is for food. Not a very high quality food, but a fairly filling food. You need a fair amount of that. Well, actually, no. Each one of these little plants is good for about one bit of plant jerky. These guys, I think I need to collect like three or four of them before I have enough for one unit of fuel. Here's some iron. Oop, wrong stuff. Iron. Bloop, bloop. Fuel. I'll just keep working my way through this field towards that small wreckage. Hey, see that recording has started thing in the corner? That's shadow play. Excuse me, jeez. I will do my best to keep those from intruding. That may be difficult under stressful circumstances, like, oh, a battle has started and I want to record something. And just sitting around waiting for it to go away might be inopportune. But, turns out that G4/Shadowplay doesn't... Hello, what are you guys running from? Doesn't... Wow. I seem to be having respiratory difficulties. Back. Copper deposit. Nice. Oh, more small wreckage, too. Anyways, what I was saying was I recorded probably a good three episodes worth of stuff before reactivating Shadowplay. I was operating exclusively on OBS, which is, you know, perfectly fine for Dwarf Fortress, which is my primary gig here. But boot. It was introducing a huge audio lag. You know, like, my voice was correct. You know, I was reacting in correct time to the video. But the game audio was, like, a good half second off, and it was just irretrievable. I couldn't do anything with it. Shadowplay seems to have that problem solved, but it doesn't recognize Empyrion as a game it can, and I quote, optimize. It doesn't think it's a real game. So I can't get all the best benefits. I don't have freedom from things popping up on the screen that might come from the desktop. It's going to show up, so apologies ahead of time for that. That's the one I just came from. Didn't I just hear about a new wreckage? But I already knew about that one. I think I'll head over there. Ooh, berries and a second wreckage. So one, two... I'm not sure how far away from the main wreckage I want to go. But I do want to collect... Hello? Oh, I thought those were berries. Sorry, apparently they weren't berries. I am getting down here into a bit of a soggy dip. That's terrible. This little section here, what is it called? Swamp Edge. Yeah, that's about right. You can find, in my experience, grains down here in the swamp. Edges. And that's very good for producing plastic later. Plastic is helpful. Well, let's just say how plastic is helpful. These herbs, though, these are also helpful in terms of making healing stuff.
Hello, little creature. How you ills? Alien insect does not mind me.
Now, I've got a question as to how it is you've got this planet with alien insects, and I don't see any now. Ooh, nice moon. Those dinosaurs we walked by a minute ago, didn't we? Was I imagining things? Why are there dinosaurs on this world full of alien insects? I don't understand. Now, another question is... from where did these wreckages come? Because I'm familiar with the larger wrecks we'll see in episodes coming soon. Here we go. Ooh, stomach pills. Very good. And these don't really, in my opinion, seem to come from them. So I think they are unrelated, which suggests this world is the cause of myriad or many a wreck. I wonder if I can configure the shadow play not to display those things in that corner. Anyways, natural sweetener. Kind of looks like some sort of evil creature, doesn't it? Did the number of bugs go down when I pick that? I don't know. But that stuff is actually pretty good for healing you, or restoring some hit points anyways. You can't do it for very long before getting indigestion, which some of those pills I just picked up are really helpful for, and not entirely easy to create. Search through the wreckage and pick up everything you find. But what if I don't want to? What if I don't want to? Let me run. Feel a bit guilty just sort of walking along with you guys, watching. This wreckage is thematically similar to the other bit that I saw, kind of this orange hull business. Perhaps they were once a thing. I guess it's not my ship. Here we go. So these are all very useful tools. This one in particular. Hello? Okay. Consider placing a portable constructor down and have a look. If you can craft something useful already. Well, sure, I can do that. Don't tell me what to do. One thing I can do is make me... Ooh! 34. I've been busy and I didn't even know it. I can make me a bunch of food. What else can I do? I can put some of this stuff away. Herbs. Kappa. Berries. What does that make me? I can make a couple of berry thingies. I kind of want more than one. I already have those. I don't think I care enough. Ooh, a gun. Yes, gun. I believe plant fibers would be helpful in those regards, but the that other business is going to take a while. Oh. Oh. Huh? You're pointed right at me, but you don't seem to be in any particular hurry. Are you a threat? Pangolin. You don't seem to be a threat. Just, where are your eyes? Oh, I think I saw them. Oh! Okay. So, not only not a threat, but kind of timid, too. That'll do. All I've been doing... Just wandering around in circles, getting resources. Wait, see?
Dream bigger! New apps, new features, new way to create!
Get off my screen. Hopefully... See? I mean, that's what we have to live with. I don't like Windows at all. Are these guys also not threatening? Very tall. Talon Guardian. They're kind of ugly. They make growly sounds, but they don't seem to care about me either. You know, if I were they, I would be a little freaked out about this alien running around in their woods. But hey, I guess they're more mature than we are. Alright. 8. It's not bad. Let's eat one now. Oh, it's still a long way to go with the rest of the stuff, though. Jeez. Oh, I've been working on the wreckage. All the live long sunset. Getting all the scrap I can get. Or at least have enough patience to withstand. Gosh. The survival tool is such a slow instrument for this kind of thing. It really does take an age. But probably by now. Yes, alright, I got everything I could possibly want. I'm going to start watching all my stuff decay, putting things away, water. Whoa, no. Stay with me. Actually, stay in there. Alright. I think I'll leave this stuff behind for now. It's not really craftable, but at least. Oh, you know what? Fuel. I'm going to need this fuel soon. And that reminds me. I got some skills to use. Let's get us a shotgun. And... I don't know. It's hard to decide sometimes because many of these things I will be able to find later. And I don't really need to learn them right away. But what should I learn right away? Ventilator... I mean, I'm going to do base stuff in the next few episodes, but not today. One thing I do need quickly, unless I accidentally stumble across some armor, I need to be able to make some, and that would be here. So, level 5 before I can even start. I still got 13 points. I'll just leave them. No, we'll do multi-tool. Any of these I can craft right now? Yes, and yes. And I can still make some of that. Let's see. Ooh, I didn't have that one. I don't have heroic tools for a lot of stuff here. But watch this. One of the nice things. Bloop! Daylight! And boom, it's all made. Ooh, excellent. Okay, so got me some weapons, got me some tools. How's about... We see about that tower that we've been instructed to see into by, you know, our PDA.
Off we go.
Silicon. Silicon, 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 silicon. Ooh, more silicon. Silicon is very valuable in the early game. So, my whole trek to get out to that alien tower might take me a bit.
Lots of detours.
Ooh, what was that? Whatever that was, I didn't go over the... Was it some sort of mushroom or something? There it is. 1 kilometer and less. This is interesting. I like this landscape. I mean, I grew up around trees. I always feel kind of... Hello. Sad if there aren't trees around. But this is nice. I don't know why. This game, like, I'll tell you, the trees, they're very late 90s. You know, very EverQuest... level kind of tree textures. you know, I haven't made a game since 1993, so I shouldn't complain.
But
the rest of the landscape, you got good vistas, you got good atmospheric attenuation, good color schemes. It's quite an attractive game overall. Just come back and fix the trees in like Alpha 9 or something, please. Thank you. Okay, pick it up. Now, I know this tower for the trap that it is because I have played many times. You guys may not... Ooh. Whoa, whoa. That's an interesting effect. Here I was just saying how good the textures were. That's not quite right. Alright. Trap set. Bust through hidden wall. You know? Spoilers! Wait for a moment. Look at the textures. Realize, hey, wait, it's the same texture. So whatever's being said is being said in triplicate. Which I guess means these guys are like actuaries or something. They need everything signed in triplicate. R, G, and B. So, something's going to happen. Things are going to happen. I'm going to shoot things. And life will go on somehow. Come on. Do it. Trigger. Listen to that. What am I not doing right? I'm getting radiation, too. Use lever. Didn't I use lever? I used the lever. Alright, I guess I somehow magically got ahead of the trigger mechanism. But... come on. The symbols are unknown and also seem heavily weathered. The tower must be very old. It is not an active station of any kind. Maybe a grave, a memorial? One symbol group on the panels is repeated over. Oops, something is happening behind the red panel. As you can tell, I was anticipating that. Boom. Okay, so the wall blows out. And as we leave, attention enemy creatures at your position. They can actually be pretty friggin' dangerous if they don't show up in the floor, which they often do, just like so. Oh, by the way, I need to load my weapon first. It's a good thing they just show up on the floor, right? And then I can't even get it. Okay. Usually there's two. Hello, other planet. Anybody see the second one? Ugh. Dude, you're facing the wrong way! Alright, at least I can loot this one. Ooh, and level 4 achieved! Alright, to build a base, craft base starter and constructor and place it on... Oh, that's a temp. No, it's actually instructions. Oh, no wonder I can't find it. I took it up. Alright, so let's head back to the wreckage, because that seems to be what it wants us to do. And good enough. We're almost 20 minutes in. Good question, though. What for you do you guys think? What for you are going to watch this? How long do you think an episode of this should be? Oh, spiders. Very, very good. Spiders are not... Actually, no, I got a shotgun. I can deal with them. No, really. 20 minutes? 15 minutes? 10 minutes? I'm not sure if I can tell a cohesive story or narrative in just 10, but who knows? I just understand also that, you know, with me, I go out on YouTube and I look at stuff and I'm like, is this worth 10 minutes of my life? You know what I mean? Wait a minute.
I can make me a meat. That's worth 10 minutes of my life.
Okay, so I'm going to cut it off here. Presumably they'd like me to turn this into a base. I don't want to. I have other ideas in mind. So I'll cut it off there, and we'll decide what to do next time.